Good morning, everyone. I'd like to welcome you to our Northwest District Ministers Association Joint Spring Ohegan Service. I'd like to welcome our guest speaker this morning, Reverend Mukojima from the Mountain View Buddhist Temple. Thank him for joining us. And I hope that our fellow Northwest District Assistant Minister, Reverend Jim Work, is feeling better. He had an accident and has to have some surgery on his leg from what we understand. This morning, we'll begin today's Ohegan service with the chanting of the Kammuryo Jikyo Saho, which is the ritual on the Sutra of Contemplation of the Buddha of Immeasurable Life. This will be first Shishindai and Hanjisan Zenjo by Reverend Tadao Koyama of the Togoma Buddhist Temple, followed by Nembutsu by Reverend Yuki Sugihara of the Oregon Buddhist Temple, and then the actual Contemplation Sutra, followed by Nembutsu and Echo by Reverend Kusunoki of the Spokane at Seattle Buddhist Temple. So if we could please have the senseis lead us in the sutra chanting.
Namanda, Snamanda, 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 Snamanda. Shishin keirei na Tam ni ga to to 剣半部弱の威光衆光者側門門剣不特性性と邪剣分有人公戦車赤一戦上司邪剣分有人公公三子弱分人成功赤一公春子弱分人有尿赤一尿騎士海前者と一緒不意し、違法違法せよ。行と精神、被害不特景気、他遊園し高校、三四遊園地四宝石四四章赤い章不宝館宝岩木米宝天聖と理職部有聖徒諮問可能特事象探縁聖母信仰創水業他心交渉し探心家子孫孫他人超乎不備界愚木衛無縁後者と必修用意性安静検証長期三春四神爆戦死悲剣今夜過去戦車意志方針交異業恐怖戦業気伏死流天要戦部位弱死他継承孤独産業の憂霊戦生者赤死生不敬死生因文縁祈祷三業聖聖死聖聖徒聖者因果作業特別聖聖投影異性不戦死法知他心故意相談不可知微生生有知他心故意小予選赤気小小水気心上昇不法さ創作水気外液上司 水気石線根海線生徒神戸伊勢院や有欲生生徒非修士兼兼他高三生徒伊勢地方尊厳史駅主知事生徒支援機主査士本番所有地社用地
なもあびたあふなもあびたあふなもあびたあふなも
シ 上破棄千番肉やば天塩分炭金石不信庫陸州万肉なゆた高下左右春美観発酵優先炎天上後守備三不願上司大海水聖破棄分娩新生膀胱炎出神戸上守備三皮膚炎行上破棄育三線大戦正解陽炎行中有破棄万肉大豊高下砂花腐一一花腐液優秀多ブス花放射医師者無量師父有発番師戦勝一一勝各有発番師戦水系公一一公福有発番師戦公米一一公米変勝司法世界連夫修正世修夫者気公米昇降休養家夫不可屈折担当欲症霊心眼見検視死者石鹸司法一斉勝負意見勝負子米連夫三倍差し感謝米官一斉不信意官不信子越見不信不信者大使非使異部縁使摂政修正差し感謝写真多生聖書不戦特部聖人志向知者養頭警視定幹部領主婦幹部領主婦者小医小公寿単幹美幹発行綺麗米領憲批官発行者発番四川省庫自然桃源憲部領主婦者石鹸司法部領省府特権部領主婦庫省府県選手記市議編官一斉責審書米帝旧官差し官者米非正官ジャクタカンシャベイシャアカナHey! しいせとゆほんおおていしおゆせナモアミダブツ、ナモアミダブツ、ナモアミダブツ、ナモアミダブツ、ナモアミダブツ、ナモアミダブツ、ナモアミダブツ、ナモアミダブツ、ナモアミダブツ、ナモアミダブ
ツ。Now at this time I'd like to ask Ken Gardner of the Oregon Buddhist Temple to read the six paramitas that is, are found in the Orange County Buddhist Temple's service book.
Six paramitas. Dana, giving. May I be generous and helpful. Sila, guidance. May I be guided by the Buddhist precepts. Kshanti, tolerance. May I regard the mistakes of others with sympathy. Virya, perseverance. May I do my best in all things. Dhyana, meditation. May I reflect deeply on my life through the Buddha's teachings. Prajna, insight. May I understand the meaning of Namo Amida Butsu.
Now, this time, I'd like to introduce our guest speaker for this Ohigan service, Reverend Yushi Mukojima of the Mountain View Buddhist Temple. Reverend Mukojima has been assigned to the Buddhist Churches of America since 2002. He has served at the Seabrook Buddhist Temple in New Jersey, the Visalia Buddhist Temple in the Central California area, the San Diego Buddhist Temple, and he has been at the Mountain View Buddhist Temple for, I think, about 7 years now. He is born in Osaka, Japan, and raised in Fukui, where his family's temple is. He is married to Mika, and they have two young children. Reverend Mukojima graduated from Ryukoku University in Japan, where he received his bachelor's degree in Buddhist history. One very interesting aspect of Reverend Mukojima is that he has also served in the Buddhist churches of South America before coming to our Buddhist churches of America. So he has experienced most of the Americas. So today he will speak to us on the special Ohigan service. So Mukojima sensei, よろしくお願いします。
Please join me, Kasho. Gandin Shikudoku, Yodo Se Issai, Dohotsu Bodaishin, Ojo Anlakoku. Namanda Butsu, Namanda Butsu, Namanda Butsu, Namanda Butsu, Namanda Butsu, Namanda Butsu.Good morning, everyone. First of all, I'd like to thank the Northwest District ministers for your kind invitation to speak at your spring Ohigan service today. I've heard so many good things about the Northwest District and the great dedication of the members there. And of course, I'm also aware of the great leadership of the North District ministers, Northwest District ministers. So it's a real privilege to join you as your guest speaker for this important joint service. I hope all of us watching this online service today will share an enjoyable experience together. Today is our annual Spring Ohigan service, one of the most important Japanese Buddhist observances. As Higan means the other shore and refers to the world of enlightenment, Pure Land, Ohigan is a precious opportunity to contemplate and learn about Amida Buddha's Pure Land. Whenever I observe this meaningful service, I feel deeply grateful to have our spiritual home, our support, which gives us the courage and the hope to face any hardships in life with the strength and gratitude. As Hiron Zensei said in introducing me, I began serving the BCA in January 2002. When I left Japan to the US, for the US, my parents accompanied me to Narita Airport to see me off. I still remember, as if it were yesterday, I left Japan full of dreams. Although it was hard for me to leave my parents, it was also a very exciting moment in my life. And I had so many happy expectations for my new life here in the US. Now, as I look back upon those days, I cannot help but to realize that I was always loved and embraced by the love and the affection of my parents. Actually, my mom and I often argued because my mom was always carping at me. She was very strict. So at the time I was to leave, I was actually pretty happy that I'll be able to live apart from my mom. But when the actual date came for me to leave, and we went together to the airport, my mom didn't talk much at all. But just before we parted, tears formed in her eyes. She squeezed my hand and said, "If you have a hard time in the US, come back to us anytime." These were the warmest and the most loving words I've ever received from her. And my heart felt so happy to hear her say them. In those days, it was sometimes upsetting for me with my mom. But I found when there is distance between us, my gratitude for her grows. I feel especially thankful for the love and affection expressed when she told me that I would have a home with them anytime. The more I think about it, the more tears come to my eyes. With her simple words, I was able to see the deep sincerity of a parent's heart. Even if I should turn my back to my parents, they will always worry about me. Also, because my mom knew that my assignment was the Seabrook Buddhist Temple in New Jersey, she packed my suitcases for me, filling them with a down jacket and the sweaters suitable for the East Coast winter, as well as many gifts for the temple members with whom I would associate. But because I was certain I could buy anything that I needed after my arrival, Every time she added something to my suitcases, I complained about the weight. But due to my mother's consideration, I didn't have any problems when I got to Seabrook. Although it was really cold there, I didn't have to go out to buy any winter clothing. Also, members really enjoyed the gifts from Japan and welcomed me warmly and openly. At that time, I fully understood that my mom's love was represented by the weight of those suitcases. I still remember how ashamed I felt about my complaining. Although my family and I were not able to go back to Japan last year due to the pandemic, it's been our custom to return there every summer to see our parents. Of course, before our annual visit, we always search out many nice gifts to make our parents smile. But when we arrive, they welcome us and conditionally saying, "You don't have to worry about anything. Whenever you return home, you should come with your hands empty." Every time we hear these words, we feel embraced in the world of their unconditional love. It is deeply gratifying to have a home where we are always welcomed just as we are. As we go through our lives, each of us has two worlds. One of them is the world we go out into, and the other is the world we come home to. For example, the world we go out into means we may leave home to go to school, work, the temple, and so on. For these worlds, we have to prepare something which meets their requirements. For example, when we go to school or work, if we have homework or an assignment, we must prepare and finish it beforehand. And although our temples always welcome everybody, we also assume that any visitors will dress appropriately. Without clothes, unfortunately, we would never be accepted there. In my case, for example, I have to prepare my Dharma talks for each Sunday service or funeral. If I appeared at the podium without having prepared a Dharma talk, I would surely be criticized by my members afterwards. If this happened too often, there would be no place for me at the temple. In other words, if we cannot meet the requirements of a group, we may not be successful in being accepted in that group's world. Therefore, we can truthfully say that the world we go out into is a harsh world. On the other hand, the world that we can return to without much preparation or concern is very much the world we come home to. This is a place of unconditional acceptance. It is where we are always welcome, even if we go empty-handed, and where we can return without worry, just as we are. In this sense, we can say that our home is the world we come back to That makes sense, that. But when we turn our eyes to the world of impermanence, we realize that our home is not actually a real world we come home to. It is only temporary. Even if we believe that it is our true home, it is quite possible that it might be destroyed by fire or earthquake, leaving us homeless. And even if our home is harmonious, once we lose our beloved family members, our home will no longer be the world we come home to with its profound sense of security. Then, for Nembutsu followers, what's the real world we come home to in this life? It is actually the Pure Land established for all the sentient beings by the primal vow of Amida Buddha. The Pure Land is where there is no greed, no anger, no attachment, and no suffering, but where there is only enlightenment, full of wisdom and compassion. The Pure Land will accept and reunite us with all beings in harmony, just like we are lovingly received by our parents whenever we return home. Fortunately, we have been walking together along the path of the Nembutsu. The Nembutsu is the path to the Pure Land, where we are accepted just as we are, and able to attain Buddhahood unconditionally when our lives end. Yes, it is indeed the real world our lives come home to, namely Higan, or the Pure Land. In the opening meditation, I shared with you the Ikomo, which always comes at the end of most sutra chantings. Gannishikudoku, yodo se issai, dohotsu odaishin, ojo anlakkok. This is a very famous verse from Kangyosho, the commentary on the meditation sutra written by Shantao, one of the seven Pure Land masters in Jodo Shinshu tradition. I know there are many Sangha members who can chant this verse without looking at the service book. In our school, this Ikoku translates as, let's share the virtue of the Nembutsu equally with all the sentient beings, entrusting ourselves completely to the primal vow, and walk together to birth in the Pure Land. As this verse appears at the end of most of our daily sutra chantings, we know how important it is to keep this spirit all the time. Through this verse, Shantao encourages us to sincerely embrace the Nembutsu teaching by reminding us that Pure Land is the spiritual home for those now living. He clearly shows us that for all of us living in this world of impermanence, the Pure Land should be our spiritual support and the nourishment, giving us great peace of mind, because our lives are full of suffering and not everything will turn out as we desire. So Amida Buddha is continually guiding us toward the true world, the Pure Land, by calling to us by his wisdom and compassion. Amida Buddha's calling voice is our utterance of the Nembutsu, Namo Amida Butsu, Namanda, Namanda. Living with the Nembutsu means we move in the direction of the Pure Land where we transcend our ego and the selfish nature while being nurtured by the Nembutsu, filled with Amida Buddha's wisdom and compassion. Jodo Shinshu doesn't teach us that we are only liberated in the afterlife when we are born in the Pure Land. Certainly, we will achieve the perfect and the true enlightenment when our lives end. But our life is a journey moving with a great peace of mind toward the Pure Land. Our founder, Shinran, teaches us that once we receive Shinjin or entrust ourselves completely to the primal vow, we enter the stage of the truly settled. It means that our birth in the Pure Land to attain Buddha food is assured in this life by the virtues of Amida Buddha's great vow. Because our journey of life is also includes the world we come home to, or the Pure Land, even if we face adverse circumstances like pandemic today, we can continue to move forward with the spirit of a challenge guided by the Nembutsu teaching. That's why we are free to take the great Nembutsu path with a peace of mind. Because of the comforting assurance that we have a true home, the Pure Land, our hope and the joy become the energy and vitality which can overcome any hardships in life. The Nembutsu shows us how important it is to realize that we are able to fulfill our lives because of the assurance we have a true home, the Pure Land. Because we fully understand where our lives will return in our afterlife, we are able to live our fragile lives at this moment, just as we are, fully, happily, and harmoniously, with the deepest feelings of gratitude for the primal vow of Amida Buddha. I believe that this is a true way to live as Jodo Shinshu Buddhists. Today, as we observe the spring Ohigan service, I've talked about the true world we come home to, or the Pure Land, by first talking about my mother's love, which awaits me whenever I return home. I hope all of us will appreciate Ohigan, our precious Buddhist tradition, for giving us this wonderful opportunity to seek the way of awakening while we both think and learn about Amida Buddha's Pure Land. Let's relish the joy of and gratitude of having our true and real spiritual home in Amida Buddha's Pure Land. Again, thank you very much for having me as your guest speaker to share the Buddha Dharma with you today. Please join me in Gassho. Let's share the virtue of the Nembutsu equally with all sentient beings, entrusting ourselves completely to the primal vow and walk together to birth in the Pure Land. Namanda butsu 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 namanda butsu.
Thank you, Sensei. Will you just continue on with your Japanese Dharma talk?
Hi, minasan, ohayou gozaimasu. 本日はノースウェスト教区の春季彼岸法要にお招きいただきまして誠にありがとうございます。 パンデミックの影響で何かと不自由な生活が続いておりますが、ノースウェスト教区の開教師先生方、そして門信徒の方々とオンラインでこのような尊いご講演を結ばせていただきましたこと、大変、嬉しく思っております。限られた時間ではございますが、お念仏の御教えを通して皆さんと共に有意義な時間を過ごしてまいりたいと思います。さて、年に2回春と秋にお勤めするお彼岸法要ですが、毎年この時期を迎えるたびに私たちの命のふるさとである彼岸、つまりお浄土についてさらにより深く味わわせていただいております。先ほど平野先生がご紹介くださいましたように、私がアメリカに着任したのが2002年の1月。まあ、だいぶ昔の話ではありますが、私が日本を旅立つ日、成田空港で両親に見送られながら、希望と期待に胸を膨らませて飛行機に乗り込むあの日のことを今でも鮮明に覚えております。今改めて当時のことを振り返ってみますと、私はいつも両親の深い愛情によって育まれていたんだなということに気づかされます。まあ、実は恥ずかしながら、私の母親とは日本にいる間よく不思議喧嘩をしておりました。まあ、いつも口うるさい母親でしたから、アメリカで両親と離れて生活できるということが本当に楽しみでしかなかったんですけれども、アメリカへ旅立つ日が近づくにつれて、母親の口数は少なくなり、寂しそうな表情がたびたび顔に出ていたのを覚えています。そして出発の日、空港に向かう道中、明るく取り繕う母親ではありましたから、いざ別れの瞬間、母親の老いた目元からは大粒の涙がこぼれ、私の手をぎゅっと握りしめて、辛いことがあったらいつでも帰ってきていいんだよと、なんとも嬉しい、なんとも温かい言葉を頂戴しました。いつもそばにいるとうるさくおせっかいに感じる母親の存在も、その距離が遠くなれば遠くなるほど、なんともありがたい存在であることに気づかされ、また、あんたの帰る場所はいつでもあるんだよという母親のこの上ない愛情に涙が出るほど感激しました。実は出発前、私の赴任先がシーブルック仏教で書いたと分かると、母親はニュージャージーの冬の寒さを心配して、暖かいセーターやダウンジャケット、そして門信徒さんへのお土産などいろんな場面を想定して荷物を準備していました。私は必要なものは現地に着いてから購入すればいいと楽観的に考えておりましたから、母親が私のスーツケースに荷物を詰め込むたびに、これ以上重くしないでくれと言ってね、母親に文句ばかり言っていました。しかし、その荷物のおかげで、現地に着いてから防寒対策もしっかりしていて、何ら困ることもなく、シューブルク仏教会のご本当には、日本からのお土産を大変喜んでいただいて、盛大に歓迎してもらいました。その時初めて、息子が新天地で何不自由ないようにと、万全を期して送り出す母親のこの上ない愛情が、あのスーツケースの重さであったんだなと気づかされ、目に熱いものを感じました。昨年はコロナの影響で日本に帰ることはできませんでしたが、アメリカに赴任してから年に一度は両親に会うために帰省しております。帰国するにあたって両親に喜んでもらえるようたくさんのお土産を用意するんですが、日本に着くなり 母親は決まって家に帰ってくる時ぐらいは手ぶらで帰ってきなさいと言って無条件で迎え入れてくれます。この言葉を聞くたびに何度も温かい親の無条件の世界に包まれます。私たちは人生において二つの世界を持っている。行く世界と帰る世界。例えば行く世界とは、私が日本を立ってアメリカに行く、また家を出て仕事や学校、仏教会に行く、まあ、このような世界は必ず行く先々の条件に合うよう努めなければなりません。もしそれを怠れば、決して受け入れてもらえない厳しい世界なんです。仏教界はどんな人でも歓迎いたしますけれども、最低条件、服は着てもらわなくてはなりません。裸でのお参りは断られてしまいます。開教師で言えば、少なくとも日曜礼拝や葬儀で法話を用意しなければ御門徒さんから見放されてしまいます。このように行く先々でそこの条件を満たすことができなければ、全く受け入れてもらえない厳しい世界、これを行く世界と言います。一方、何も用意しないで安心して門をくぐれる世界、これを帰る世界と言います。土産の一つ持たなくても無条件で受け入れてくれる世界、ありのままの自分で帰れる世界。その意味で、両親や家族が待っている我が家を帰る世界と言えるのではないでしょうか。しかし、私たちが生きる無常の世界に目を向けてみますと、この我が家も実は本当の帰る世界ではなく、一時的なものでしかないということに気づかされます。この世界でいくら我が家といえども、火事や地震が起これば一瞬にして帰る場所を失ってしまいます。またどんなに和やかな家庭であっても、愛する家族を失うことで我が家はもう以前のように安心して笑顔で帰る世界ではなくなってしまいます。では念仏者にとって、この世における真の帰る世界とは一体どこにあるのかと言いますと、これこそ阿弥陀様のご本願によって築かれた光と命極みなき悟りの世界、お浄土なんです。このお浄土は、私たちが家に帰るたびに両親に無条件で受け入れてもらえたように、生きとし生けるものをそのままありのままで受け入れ、阿弥陀様のお働きで仏とさせていただくのです。幸いにも私たちはお念仏の道を歩ませていただいております。阿弥陀様が示してくださったお念仏は極楽浄土に向かう道であり、このお浄土こそ私たちの命が終えたとき、仏となって無条件でお帰りと迎え入れてくださる真の帰る世界、つまり彼岸なんです。ご三代で拝読させていただきました、絵光句は、七高僧の一人である善道大師が表された勧行書に出てくる大変有名な疑問です。願に宿読、平等性一切、東仏菩提心、往生安楽国。この絵光句は読経の最後でよくお勤めしますから、皆さんにとってとても親しみのある疑問だと思います。浄土真宗におけるこの絵光句の解釈は、お念仏の功徳を分け隔てなく平等にあらゆる人に伝え、阿弥陀様より賜った同一の信心を起こして、共に往生浄土の道を歩んでまいりましょうという、お念仏を喜ばれた善道大師の大いなる願いが表され、この無常の世界に生きるすべてのものにとって お浄土こそが命のふるさとであり、心のよりどころであって、人生の糧となるべき存在なんだということを明らかに示してくださっております。親鸞上人は、ひとたび信心を得れば、正常中の位に定まると教えてくださっております。これは、臨時を待たずとも、阿弥陀様のお働きによって、私たちの命は必ず仏として浄土に往生することが約束されているということなんです。浄土真宗は、死んでから浄土に往生して初めて救われるという教えではありません。真の、確かに真の悟りを開いて仏となるは臨終の時ではありますが、私たちの人生は浄土に向かって歩む大安心の旅路なんです。人生という旅も、お浄土という真の変える世界があるからこそ、たとえ人生の苦境に立たされようとも、パンデミックで不自由な生活を強いられようとも、それに立ち向かう勇気と希望を持って、あらゆる困難を念仏の御教えと共に乗り越えてゆくことができるんです。私の帰る世界をはっきりと示してくださるお念仏によって、今私たちは救われているんです。帰る世界が定まった命だからこそ、ありのままの人生を感謝のうちに精一杯燃やし尽くして生き抜いていくことができるんです。これこそ真の念仏者の生き方ではないでしょうか。本日のこの尊いご法を通して、すべての命が必ず帰らせていただく極楽浄土の世界を忍びつつ、帰る世界を持つことの喜びを今一度深くかみしめながら、皆さんと共に法音社徳のお念仏を相続させていただきたいなと切に願っております。本日のお聴も誠にありがとうございました。それでは合唱をお願いいたします。阿万陀仏の阿万陀仏の阿万陀仏の阿万陀仏の阿万陀仏阿万陀仏の阿万陀仏の阿万陀仏阿万陀仏の阿万陀
仏。 Thank you, Mukojima sensei. All of us, whether English speaking or Japanese speaking, can understand the unconditional love of our mothers. So thank you. At this time, we'd like to call on Lynn Ray Hubbell of the Tacoma Buddhist Temple for the reading of Jodo Shinshu Creed.
Jodo Shinshu Creed. I put my trust in the vow of Amida Buddha. Reciting Namo Amida Butsu, let us live life to the utmost with strength and joy. I look to the light of Amida Buddha, constantly reflecting upon myself. Let us strive to live a life of gratitude. I shall follow the teaching of Amida Buddha. Awakening to the right path, let us share the true Dharma with others.I rejoice in the compassion of Amida Buddha, mutually respecting and aiding each other. Let us endeavor to work for the good of all.
Thank you, Lynn Ray. So this time in concluding today's Ohigan service for the Northwest District Ministers and Northwest District,I'd like to thank you all for joining us. I'd like to especially thank Reverend Mukojima for making the time to speak to us. Our next joint service will be for the memorial service for Prince Shotoku, which will be shown on April 25th. So until that time, I know things are starting to get better. People are getting vaccinations.Let's please still stay safe, mask, socially distance, and wash your hands. All right. So thank you. We'll join close with Gassho, please. Namo Amida Butsu. Namo Amida Butsu. Namo Amida Butsu. Thank you, everyone.